Good morning, students. Today you are going to study about the flotation. Gravitation chapter we have completed. In that only this flotation part is there. It is related to the liquids and we are going to study about this. Okay, first topic we are going to study is thrust and pressure. I will explain you about the thrust over here. What is thrust? In A standard you have studied force and pressure lesson. In that you have studied what is force. It is a push or pull on an object. Okay, so similarly here same it is force, thrust means. Okay, but what you are going to study, you are going to study here for the liquids. So if an object, suppose can see I am taking a pen, okay, and this is my hand on the surface. If a force is acting on a surface, but how it should be? It should be perpendicular, okay, to the surface. If a force is acting perpendicular or normally to the surface, it is called as thrust. Okay, means force which is applying vertically or normally perpendicular, it is called as thrust. Very simple definition it is. As you know, thrust and force are same, so the quantity is also same, as it is a vector quantity, and the SI unit is same as force, which is Newton. Okay, now we are going to study about the pressure. Pressure also in 8th standard you have studied that it is force per unit area. Same here, instead of force you will write here thrust per unit area. Means what will be the definition of pressure? It is the thrust acting per unit area of the surface is called the pressure. Here you are going to study about liquid. Okay, that's why we are using the term thrust. Thrust, one more example I can give you. When the rocket is launching, that time you can see the rocket exerts fire. Okay, the fire which is coming out from the rocket, it exerts a pressure on the surface of the ground, then it moves forward. So here also the force which is acting on the ground is perpendicularly or it is normal to the ground. That's why there also it is called as thrust. So here pressure P equal to thrust. So instead of thrust I have written force F divided by area A. Here unit force is Newton, area's unit is meter square, which it can be also written as Newton meter minus 2. Why minus 2? I have explained here. When it is at the denominator, what happens if you are taking above, then this 2 sign gets converted into minus 2. That's why it is Newton meter minus 2, which is also called as Pascal. In short, it is written as Pa. Okay, so what it explains that the pressure exerted on area A of 1 meter, if 1 meter area is taken, a pressure exerted on that surface will be the thrust 1 Newton. Okay, so here we have completed the pressure. We are going to see some other quantities here. You can see other units of pressure which you are going to study is the bar. Pascal you have already studied in 8th standard. Now you will study about the bar. So what is the value of 1 bar? 1 bar is 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. Then second unit is millibar. Okay, then third is ATM. ATM means what? It is atmospheric pressure. It is related to the atmospheric pressure. You have studied the instrument such as barometer. Okay, in that this ATM unit is used. So 1 ATM is equals to 1.05 into 10 raised to 5 Newton per meter square. And the fourth unit is mmHg. What is the meaning of mmHg? When you visit to the doctor, that time you can see that you are, when the BP is get checked, the blood pressure, you can see the mercury level increases above. Okay, in that instrument, that time what happens, the height of the mercury is denoted by mm, and the because the mercury is used, that's why it is taken as Hg. Okay, so next topic we are going to study about the density. So density you have already studied before. What is the density? Density of any substance is defined as mass per unit area. For example, I will tell you an example. In this room, if 100 students are there in this room, what you can say, density is more, because at a particular volume, if more amount of substance is present or more amount of anything, mass is present, that time you are telling that the substance has more density. One more example I will tell you. Instead of 100 students, I have taken only 1 or 2 students in this room.